This week we're in Orewa, just north of Auckland. Beautiful beaches, a good selection of shops and cafes, and Waiwera hot pools are just down the road. We're going to spend some time relaxing as a family before we get ready for tonight's show. Give her a round of applause. You're going to have to stand up soon, but let's just see how we're going. Okay, so tell me, what is it with the feet?
I've got heel spurs on both my feet.
Right. Oh, and they are very, if any of you have had that, they are extremely painful. So we're going to...
Yeah, some days I can hardly walk at all.
Right, so we're going to sort that, and we're going to have a lovely camera shot of you walking off here in a few minutes with no pain whatsoever. Won't that be cool?
I believe it when I see it. It's been very painful.
Yep. Now, once we've worked on your feet, then I can get you to stand so I can work on your back. So tell me what's wrong with your back.
I had a major lower back strain in March.
Okay.
Yeah. I was hospitalised with it, so it's quite bad.
That is bad, yeah. Normally they send you home with Panadol, don't they? Right. Now, you'll notice me blowing my nose a lot, and that's because as more energy comes through me, more life force, more chi, it makes my eyes stream, it makes my nose stream. All right, so we're going to work on the heel spurs first. If I can get you to take off your shoes, please. And they're beautiful shoes, those. Here we go. And,
thanks.
Yep. What's your first name?
Carolyn.
Carolyn. Cool. If they were my size, you might not be seeing them again.
Hush puppies.
Cool.
Anything comfortable.
It's always the left hand first. Or usually. And heel spurs are very... the nice one about this for TV is that Carolyn couldn't walk without pain on her face with heel spurs, so if they do go, we'll know, because she'll be smiling. Now, everything... Say that again.
I can't walk on the flat floor at all.
Oh, okay. That'll be good to see then, won't it, eh? Now, everything in our bodies is made of vibration. We think of these bodies as solid, but they're actually made of molecules that are vibrating. And when the energies are flowing through those molecules, everything's fine, we've got health. But when it's not, that's when disease sets in. And usually we're not at ease with something in our lives. So if my bladder's giving me a problem, what is it I'm peed off about? Yeah? And if it's my bowel where there's disease, what is the rubbish I don't want to let go of? Yeah? If it's heart disease, where am I not being loving? Yes, so we can actually find the underlying reason for lots of different conditions. And over in America, there's a lady called Louise Hay. Some of you, I'm sure, will have heard of her. My leg's going now. Who has written a fabulous book called You Can Heal Your Life. And in it, you can look up all the different conditions, including heel spurs, and find out what the condition is, what the belief or the mindset is that is causing the disease on a physical level. Now, the reason this kind of healing works, it's all sound and it's all vibration, it's light as well, as evidenced from the photographs. Your body is the very best thing for healing yourself. What I'm removing is the obstacles to healing. That's all I'm doing. Right. I think I'm working on the other one. Any sensations, Carolyn?
No.
Nothing yet? No. You'll see my consciousness is quite free to talk to you guys while the healing's taking place, because it's not me doing the healing, which is really good, because if anybody does experience pain, sue him. Now, here in New Zealand, myself and other alternative health practitioners were not allowed to diagnose. It's against the law. Only doctors who have access to x-rays, blood tests and the like can do diagnoses. When I see people privately, I always make sure they have seen a doctor. I'd hate to remove the pain and then be left with cancer. I don't think it would happen, but you've got to be on the safe side, so you always make sure a person's seen a doctor. Now, as I'm looking at this ankle, it's going green. Now, I know Carolyn's trousers are green, but I can see green.
It's going to fall off.
No, it's not gangrene. I can see green light beneath, and that's healing light. Very often the healing energy is green. Yeah. Yeah, and very often that we hear the phrase green-fingered people with plants, and that's what that relates to. Talking till I'm blue in the face, that's your throat chakra, which is blue. Red with anger, your aura goes bright red when you're angry, or passionate for that matter. The sound is used to break things up, a bit like in conventional medicine, we might use sound to disperse gallstones, yeah, or kidney stones, maybe. Right then, let's see how we're doing. So if you want to stand first of all. That speaker and walk back. All right, now this has happened to me once before where the doctor sometimes just walking and moving just releases that last little bit of stuff. Well, she looks a lot better than when she first hobbled on, doesn't she? How are you feeling? So, go on, gentleman there with a question. Now, let's just find out. I'll just ask, I'm just going to move my consciousness and see, if I had heel spurs within me, what would I be holding on to? It's going to be not feeling supported, it's going to feel a betrayal. There'll have been a betrayal in your life that was almost unforgivable. Well, there we go. Yeah? If you think about Achilles' heel, it's our weakness, but two of them, it's like, ugh. Yeah? And that's the energy that's being held in. Now, a lady asked me earlier about, you know, when did I first start seeing spirit? When I first started seeing spirit, I was with a group of about 64 people, and somebody expressed concern about what was happening to the earth. And I stood up in front of this group of people, and back then I wouldn't stand up like I do now, and I said, not to worry, spirit world are aware of what's unfolding on the physical plane, everything's going to be all right, and I'm here to give people proof. That was like 19 years ago, then I sat back down thinking, oh my goodness, what just came out of my mouth? But if you can imagine, I can do this, I do this on a regular basis, with all kinds of condition, eczema, asthma, cancers, emphysema, you know, conventional medicine is missing something. It's missing the elephant in the room. Mind, body, spirit are interconnected. You can't heal anything in isolation. And what can modern medicine cure? Can't even cure a cold. This healing is going to the core, the cause, cause of the condition. And it's a thought or a belief or an emotion that you're holding, that you've forgotten you're holding. You think it's real because you've held it for as long as you can remember. But gradually, it's affecting your physiology and it causes you pain. Now, the interesting thing is then, as these heel spurs disappear, so also does the emotion that Caroline's been holding that caused the heel spurs. Isn't that cool? Yeah. Wouldn't you like to be able to heal like this? This is what I teach people to do. That's my job, is there's not enough of me to go around, so I teach people to do this. Now, this is just like a little clean-up now. To energy. Great time for photographs. Oh, surgeon's happy now with the left foot. I like it when he's happy. Oh. Right, Caroline, if you'd like to try standing again. I told you we'd get a smile in, didn't I? How's it feeling? I haven't finished that one yet, don't panic. He's just said the right one, this one nearest me, the left one's really, really good. He doesn't even hurt at all. Tell them. So now the reason I'm doing this is to, and this is the entity talking now rather than Jeanette, so the reason that the entity is doing this is to cause a shift within your consciousness, to start you thinking about who you truly are and why you are really here. Because it isn't to work a bit harder to pay off a bit more debt. That's not why you've incarnated as the fabulous beings that you are in these physical forms. And on your deathbeds, many of you realize, I just wish, and number one on that list is, I just wished I'd found out who I was, or I'd been more true to me, or I wished I'd forgiven somebody, yeah? It's not, I wished I'd worked a few more hours overtime. It's not. I wished I'd shopped a bit more at that warehouse. No. No. All right, now one of the things that this entity said to me two shows ago, it was after the show and it was the next morning. Now, Caroline, I'm just wanting to know, what's the sensation in your right foot at the moment? Any sensation?
No.
No? Cool. Right, so this is going back two shows, and it was the morning afterwards, and one of my entities came in and said, you do realise that the reason people come to your shows, your mediumship shows, is because they want to feel better. They think, they have the belief that receiving a message from a loved one will make them feel better. How about we just skip to the feeling better? If you tell yourself you need a message from a loved one in spirit world to feel better, then that will be your reality, that will be true for you. It's something you tell yourself, it's a belief. It's not, strictly speaking, true. What you really want is to feel better. Everybody in this room would like to feel better on some level. Spiritually. Yeah, and that's what this entity is about, is helping you feel better. Now, the silly thing is, let's look at the words, feeling better. What it means is you've got to feel your feelings more. But you don't want to do that, do you? You just want to feel better without feeling the feelings? Can't happen. Yeah, to feel better, you've got to feel your feelings. You've got to feel the stuff that's been locked up. Much of it from childhood. As well-intentioned as our parents are, they don't always have the time. They don't always speak to us with kind words. They don't always listen. Come to think of it, we often don't listen. And very often, I'm quite used to this. All of a sudden, there's a movement, and it's the entity just possesses us to do something. The most extreme thing I've seen is a patient be lifted out of the chair. Now, I am so grateful that that lady's husband came with her to the session, because if he hadn't, he would never have believed what happened. So what happened for you just then with your legs?
I just wanted to put my feet on the ground because I've been down there for about 5 months.
Cool. I feel like a dwarf doing this. Right. Let's try them both out now. Let's take them for a test drive. Just let you feel my fingers. How's that feeling?
Oh, amazing.
So now we can do your back. Yeah, because now she can stand properly for me to do the back, you see. You enjoying this? Right, so I'm going to get you, Caroline, to stand here if you would. Now, when the entity asks you to stand in a certain place, he means exactly there. Okay, that's good. Now, this is lower back. Oh, yes, if anybody's got a lower back pain, especially on those chairs, no, I'm only kidding. And you'd like to receive healing for this, just intend now that you receive into your body whatever aspects of this sound are appropriate for you. Only take in the bits that you need. And on a conscious, an unconscious level, you will know what it is your body needs. Right, some few steps around, Caroline, and just notice how your back feels.
This feels free and it feels peaceful.
Face there again, he's not finished with you yet. Just get you to just hold my hands, just see how cold they are. Sometimes think it sounds like a swarm of bees. I don't ever make myself produce sound because I've seen firsthand just how powerful it is. And if I were to use the wrong sound at the wrong pitch, in the wrong way, I could actually do you harm. So I only ever let the entities use sound. I have had people come up to me and they say, oh, you heal like I do. I've done this sound training course. I haven't had any training courses. Everything has been done through me by spirit. So it's through years of listening, if you like, to spirit world. And that's it, allow yourself to move if that's how you feel. Yeah. I know. Save people a fortune in doctor's bills, eh? But the thing is, it's very sad, but I get called a quack. But the energy is going to the cause of the problem, which is thought or a feeling. Thought if it's in the head, feeling if it's stored somewhere in the body. E. somebody's happy. That's good. I like it when he's happy. Right, Caroline, if you'd like to walk around.
It was really weird.
Go on, tell them. Talking to one of our cameras.
No, I just, when you did it before as well, when you first started, it was like a little tremor going through my body. Like, it was very weird.
Right, walk around and see how that back feels.